requirement.
All right, so the work session will now begin. So Ken, coming in, just so you know, in front of you, Mara put a consolidation of November 18th projects, which is actually missing two, and then which were pre-approved from the 18th. And then you'll see three that are circled in green. Those are the ones we're going to discuss.
Okay.
Starting with 626 Hollywood Place, which was a window installation. And I guess time to discuss.
I had the same question that I had the last time. There was no project representative here at that time. And addressed anywhere in the submittal. And they are not, one of them isn't even pictured. And I ask for a clarification if these two windows were also being replaced, and we got no response. If they're not being replaced, we'll have a mixture of white and bronze color windows on the front elevation. And the bronze color windows that are existing also have grills. They didn't provide a picture of the whole front elevation. So here's a picture if y'all want to see it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had that same comment. And then that front bay is going to be removed. And the window that they have kind of placed in the image is interrupting the trim at the front. And I know that there's a header up there, so I just don't think that what they have drawn is really feasible. I think that window would be smaller. An additional comment.
Hopefully we'll have a project representative here this evening who can clarify things for us.
Yeah.
We did not let them know it was essential they be here this evening.
Just to clarify your comments, because I might have been in trouble hearing. Is it the color issue? Is that, or the fact that there's some windows remaining that are staying brown and there's, okay.
And they're on the front elevation.
Yeah.
Ken, if you want to take a look at this picture, we can pass it down to you, because the front elevation is not shown in the packet, the full front elevation.
Yeah.
It's not the color, it's the contrast.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's completely different on the front.
I didn't see that picture.
This didn't come.
Oh.
Yeah.
I took that picture because we didn't have
it. Yeah. That would have been nice to have.
Yeah.
I got in my car this evening, was driving halfway here, and I realized I had the wrong packet. So I went back to get the right packet, and I left the right packet on the front seat of my car. Wrong packet, but we'll get through.
Okay.
So the other question I had on this one, I thought we asked this the last time about the side bay window. Is it clear on what's happening? Because if they're removing the projected roof, they say it's not attached or it's glued on, but what happens if there's no brick underneath? I don't know what the existing condition underneath that roof projection is. So there was some kind of note. It was kind of difficult to read because it was dark text on top of the brick, but I'm pretty sure it says it's glued to the face and we're going to attempt to clean it. But to me, the question is, well, what's, you know,
yeah.
I'm gonna attempt to clean it, but what if it comes off and it's a mess? I don't really know. Mm-hmm. What if there's missing brick or who knows what it is, right?
I think the inference there is this was added on later. You can kind of tell by the brick pattern. I don't know what the condition of the brick would be, but it's there, you know.
Yeah, it looks like it's over it, but yeah.
Yeah.
is really there is, as we all know.
Well, and the other inference would be that there's a brick sill below it, which wouldn't have been put in if it was a bay. So, but you got a good point about what is the condition of the bricks. So.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's really just a question that would require them here to discuss it, I think. So, but it looks like the last time on the front, they've addressed that because they're going to basically keep the roof and just replace those bay windows. So that was didn't that change?
No, the bay comes out.
The bay comes out.
Right.
I thought that was different on this one. It has been.
This is the front.
I'm talking about the front, the main front.
Yeah, this one.
Yeah.
Comes out.
The lower one, the first one.
Oh, yeah.
The lower one, I believe. The lower one on the front stays.
Yeah, so the roof structure is going to stay.
Yeah.
That was.
For this,
yeah. For this? No, this one, the one before it.
Oh.
I just seem to recall that was a question the last time, but maybe not. I don't know. That was a month ago.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I think you were.
Okay. I'm confused again. Are they? Are they removing the bay, or are they just replacing the windows in the bay?
I think they're replacing the windows in the bay.
Okay, all right, okay. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
And then the upstairs one, they're doing one
removing,
flush, which is an improvement.
So. Yeah, and the one on the side.
And then there's one on the side too.
Yeah, that's the one where the question is
broke the brick, or I mean the blue.
This one.
That's the one. There's a bigger picture of it too.
Oh. Okay, this is one they're removing. Okay.
There.
Got it. All right.
So that's that one. Next one is 215 Portland Terrace. There was a detached garage. Were there any comments from board members on this one?
Yeah, I just had to add a window either on the side or the back. There's two blank faces of the garage.
I have that it's okay as submitted, but just made a suggestion that they consider adding window and door trim that would match the house, and also consider adding a grill to the upper window sash to match the house. But those are suggestions only.
Must have driven by there because it wasn't included.
Yes.
That was one of my questions, if it matched the house or not.
Oops. All right. Any other comments? Not. The last one for the work session is 500 Gray.
I have some scope clarification questions on this one. On the rear dormer, the side elevations show siding on the dormer. And the rear elevation shows shingles on the face of the dormer. And I just wanted to clarify what their intent was there. Mm-hmm. And also, I wanted to clarify whether or not the front porch columns are remaining or whether they're changing the columns to the style that's shown on the illustration that they submitted. And what material will be used for the front porch steps. And then also a suggestion that they select a front door that's more in keeping with the period style of the house and retain the original side lights. And that was just a suggestion only.
Tracy or Ken, yeah. Angela.
Anything? I'm gonna run out and get my packet after we're done talking. I don't really take issue with her comments, so I'm good.
Do you want a packet to look at? Do you want one to look at real quick?
Well, I got them in my car. I just brought the wrong one up. So.
Oh, we've got 15 minutes.
Yeah.
We got plenty of time. We'll wait for you, Ken.
You don't have to wait on me.
The door should remain open, so you should be able to get it. Pardon? You should be able to get it. Yeah, they should be
up front. Should be. Yeah.
You have to do anything?
No.
That's what happens when we skip a meeting.
Yeah, no, and then have turkey. I did on the last one, I did want to share because I was just kind of looking over my notes. I did want to share. I did have a couple comments. These were suggestions, but my comments were consider adding a window to the north elevation, you know, in the closet or bathroom. And I'm thinking more on the exterior, just sort of this composition is, you know, interrupted on one side. It's missing something for me. And then I made the same comment about the kitchen on the east elevation. Same comment I've made before about consider adding a window or keeping one of the windows on that deck side. For the exterior and the interior both would benefit. And again, those were suggestions. So standing at your stove and seeing out in your yard is a nice experience as a cook. But I know. So I just wanted to finish because I know Ken had walked out. So
yeah.
But that was my only comments on that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm very happy that it's being saved. I live right around the corner from there, and when I saw changes going on, I was crossing my fingers that someone save it. So yeah, it's great.
Yeah, you never know what they're cleaning up to do.
Yeah.
Right. It looks like a
new house. In sad shape.
Yeah, it just needs a little work, but it doesn't seem like the stuff.
Mm-hmm. One of the things, just to remind the board members, we also have meeting minutes from November 4th. Just to make sure you guys have looked at those. I know that was a while ago. Yeah, Kelly, the last time we were here, we had technical difficulties. Looks like we worked all that out.
We have a whole new system.
That's.
Oh, really?
That's,
yeah.
That's a way to work it out.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Okay.
So it's pretty state of the art.
Yeah.
Somebody said when they first used it with the council meetings and stuff, you can do a lot with the cameras. You can focus in on individuals.
Oh, wow.
Different things like that. Wow. So it was like C-SPAN.
Yeah. So do you control that from
that
dashboard.
Just doing the
overall.
The one.
She would like me to learn how to focus in on each one of you.
I'm good like this.
It's interesting though, people don't know who's talking, right? They just
That's true.
They don't know who's talking. I never thought about that. Whatever it is. Not like this. Now, on the Zoom ones, when we were doing, you guys were Zooming in.
Yeah.
You know, you could see individually who was speaking at any given time. We're not there yet with this. Might get there.
But they are doing that for city council? And then I guess anytime someone from the public gets up to talk, they would do the same.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's cameras back here too.
That's right. We'll see him.
One.
Don't do anything wrong. Have you been heard or seen? So for those of you who are waiting, when we initially start at 5:30-ish, we will do some basic business that the board needs to vote on a few things, and then we'll start in, Bob, our chairman, will start the meeting, those basic things first, and then we'll start with the agendas that need to be voted on. We'll be starting.
It's the tryptophan from the turkey.
Yeah,
still. Still.
All right, I think we can go ahead and get started.
Sure. Okay. Well, welcome everyone that's online and in the council chambers. Our to the Architect Review Board meeting. We just finished our work session, so the regular meeting is now underway. We have some business to take care of. First will be approval of minutes from November 4th. And all that were in attendance are here tonight, I do believe. So do I have a motion? Right.
Yeah, I'll make a motion to approve the November 4th meeting minutes as written.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Yeah, I don't think Ken was there.
Sure.
No. Oh, I wasn't.
Sorry, Ken.
I'm not an aye. I'm not here. Sorry about that.
There's four.
I read them too.
Yes, that's okay. There's four of us and four voted to approve. So November 4th meeting minutes are approved. Next, we have three approvals that were left over from the November 18th meeting, where we did not meet in person. So we are going to read those through those motions tonight. So I ask board members to refer to the handout. First one is 602 Bonita. Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve 602 Benita as submitted.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? Okay, 602 Benita is approved. Next, we have 1423 Azalea. Do I have a motion?
Go for it.
I'll make a motion to approve 1423 Azalea as submitted.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? 1423 Azalea is approved. Next is 456 Ridge. Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve 456 Ridge with the clarification that all of the existing windows will remain.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Recused.
Aye. Opposed? All right. That's four votes to approve, and so that is approved. Next, we have 124 Helfstein. Do I have a motion?
I make a motion to approve 124 Helfstein as submitted.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? Helfstein is approved. 75 Webster Woods. Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve 75 Webster Woods with the clarification that the rear timber frame gable is open. The house behind will have siding to match the existing siding on the gable ends of the house.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? And then there's two that aren't on that sheet, but from the last one still, which were preliminary. The first one was 22 Wilshire, construct a new house. Do I have a motion?
Make a motion to approve 22 Wilshire based on the amended elevations received on November 18th.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed?
Opposed.
That's four in favor, one opposed. 22 Wilshire is approved. And last from November 18th is 452 East Glendale. Do I have a motion?
Make a motion to approve 452 East Glendale per the amended elevations that were received on November 17th.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? Okay, 452 East Glendale is approved. So now time warp to today. Which, by the way, I did forget to introduce everybody. I think I got off track. So
okay.
Formally, yeah. So Kelly Campbell and Will Penny are here with the city. And we have Emerson Smith online, who's a city council member. Carol Dunkey, Tracy Collins, Ken Burns, Angela Thompson, and myself, Bob Buckman, who are volunteer architects on the board. So with that, today's agenda included additional submittals. Some of them are pre-approvals. So we'll start with those. The first one is 710 South Rock Hill. Do I have a motion?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? 710 South Rock Hill is approved. Next, we have 329 McDonald Place. Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve 329 McDonald Place as submitted.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? 329 McDonald Place is approved. And then last, 407 South Old Orchard. Do I have a motion?
Make a motion to approve 407 South Orchard with the clarification that there will be a new patio with a concrete step outside the door to the screen porch.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? 407 South Orchard is approved. All right. At this point, we have three projects remaining. As we read your project, if you're here in attendance, we ask that you come up and introduce yourself at the podium. And if you're online, to raise your hand, and Kelly will join you into the meeting. First one is 626 Hollywood. Is there someone here to represent that project?
Yes, I am here.
Hi, is this so David Dean and Ken Stout?
Yes, yes, that's correct.
Okay, we have a few questions for you.
Yeah, the first question is regarding the front elevation. There were two windows on the front that aren't specifically addressed in the submittal. One is a second floor window that's in the front facing gable, and the other is the window that is on the main level, and it's just to the left of the front door. Are those windows being replaced similar to the other windows?
Yes, they are.
Okay, so they're both being replaced with white double hungs with no grills?
Yeah.
Yes, that's correct.
That's correct. Okay, thank you.
I was curious about the front bay window on the second floor. That bay is coming out, and I understand the new window is going in that existing opening, but I believe that opening is likely going to be shorter than what you have shown in the submittal based on the a probable header that's made it may exist at that bay. I was just curious if you could possibly make that window a little bit shorter in height so that that trim could continue on.
It will fit into the opening itself. We will replace that dental mold, so the look of the dental mold will be continuous all the way across. The issue is that, you know, we had a copy and paste because that'll have a CAD program to be able to put a drawing in there to really make it look like it's going to look.
Okay, so you said that trim will continue across the top?
Yes, yes, it will be.
Okay.
Okay. And then I had a question on the side bay. I guess it says here that I think it's that the roofing extension for that bay window was glued on. Are you guys sure what's underneath that? That it's brick, and are you?
It's a full brick opening. Instead of being cut into the brick face, it's just attached with adhesive. It looks like it's roofing cement with flashing. So once the bay is removed, that will all come off, and we'll get as much of that adhesive off the brick that will possibly come off without damaging the brick any further. And then the new windows will be set in place.
Is there a roll-lock sill or anything on that existing window? So I guess it used to be a punched opening and then they added that at some point. Is that what the story is?
It appears that both of those bays, yeah, both of the bays on the first floor appear to be added later than the original building.
Okay. So they do still have the roll lock sills?
Yes, there's an existing soldier course underneath the existing bay that's there now.
Okay. Ken or Angela, anything to add?
Very good.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, thank you for the explanation to David and Ken. I think we have, we're good. We'll go ahead and make a motion for 626 Hollywood. Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve 626 Hollywood with the clarification that all of the windows on the front elevation will be replaced with white windows with no grills, and that the dental trim that's existing on the front elevation will be patched to be continuous after removal of the bay. Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? Okay, David and Ken, you're approved.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, next on the list, we have 215 Portland Terrace.
Hi, I'm Drew Jennings, the owner.
Hi, Drew.
Rudy Buse, the architect.
Hi, Rudy.
Placing an existing garage. Existing garage is no windows, and both east and the west and north sides of the garage are the north side, the neighbors got all kinds of brambles in that area, and the neighbor's garage to the west is the neighbor's garage to the west is right next to the existing garage, so we put a window where there's a view.
Okay.
Side porch is meant to be used as a congregating area. Yeah.
Okay. Store firewood, maybe an outdoor TV seasonally.
Cool. Great, thanks.
So the existing garage needs to be a few joints. There's nothing architecturally that I could see interesting about it, even though it's old. And it's in pretty bad repair. And about a third of the garage has been replaced, half of the roof and other things. So it would be quite a cost to finish replacing it. And it would still not provide the storage and things we need for our family. The house we just moved in July, we used to be an old orchard, and we moved to Portland Terrace. And it's the new house is wonderful, but it's the basement has been maximized as far as it can be finished, and there's almost no storage space. So we desperately also, on top of everything else, need a little bit of elevated storage space to be able to kind of fit everything and not have it sitting out in the yard.
Okay, thank you for the information. Are there any comments from board members?
I just had a couple of suggestions, and that would be to add trim to the windows and doors that would match the first floor of your house, which is a really beautiful house. And also to consider maybe putting grills in the upper sash of that double hung. But once again, those are just suggestions, because I think it would help tie the two structures together.
Absolutely. My wife actually was saying the same things on the way out the door. So I've been in charge so far. She had some of those same ideas in mind to make it match a little better and make it a little more actually interesting, but not too much.
Yeah. Okay, great. Any other comments?
Mm-mm. Nope.
All right, I think we're good. So with that, do I have a motion on 215 Portland Terrace?
Just a clarification, do we want to add those suggestions to the motion or as an option?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're agreeable.
Yeah, it sounds good to you guys.
The trim, and what about the grills in the windows? We can make that an option.
And like Rudy said, the only issue with adding a second window is it would just be looking at. It would just be, I'll use my teacher voice.
Yeah, I was going to say, your voice projects.
The only problem with the window is it would be just looking at another garage. And nothing much else.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not close to it.
I did look at the site plan, and on the back would be the only reasonable place, because I agree the other ones, it's right at the garage. Yeah. So if they're going to put one,
So, it's my understanding that we're not suggesting the additional window. I was just suggesting the option to put the grills in the upper sash of the one window that is on the plan.
Okay, that's what I thought you were suggesting at first.
Yeah,
so we're
so those are good ideas.
Okay, so we're in favor of those, and we'll put it in the motion. Okay.
Okay. With that, do I have a motion?
I make a motion to approve 215 Portland Terrace with the following revisions. The door and the doors and window will have trim to match the existing house, and the window will have grills in the upper sash to match the existing house.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? All right, you're approved. 215 Portland Terrace.
Okay, thank you.
Drew, Rudy. You're welcome. All right, last project on the...
They'll get those in tomorrow.
Yep. Last project on the agenda tonight is 500 Gray. Is there anyone here for that project online? Please raise your hand.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi, this is Erica. I'm here with the design firm.
Okay, welcome, Erica. Mm-hmm. It's just you, Erica?
Yes, it's just me.
Okay, we saw another name and we weren't sure. No, okay, so great. We have a few questions. Who wants to start? Carol?
Yeah, I had some questions about just clarifications.
Sure.
On the dormer that's on the rear, on the side elevations, siding is shown as the wall finish material, but on the rear elevation of that dormer, shingles are shown as the wall finish material. Was that your intent, or were you going to do siding all the way around?
That's a Photoshop error. The intent is for the entirety of the dormer to have the horizontal white siding.
Okay, great. And then also on the front porch columns, are those going to be replaced with the style that's shown on the drawing, or are the existing columns remaining?
We're hoping that the existing columns are in a good enough condition that as we go to repair them, that they can remain, because they do have a nice little bit of detailing to them. But there looks like there might be some rot along the top where the decorative elements are. So we may end up replacing the whole column with something simpler and more modern, as shown in the image. So that it's sort of going to be, as we pull the thread on the sweater, what we're able to preserve there.
We understand.
Maybe
what we could do is put in the motion that the existing columns will be retained if they're in serviceable condition, but that they can also be replaced in the style that's shown on the drawing if need be.
That would be great. Thank you.
And then also, what material is going to be used for those front porch steps?
So the front porch itself is the brick, and the existing steps are also brick, but they're in pretty bad repair. So we're going to repair the porch itself so that the adjacent brick patio planters and the patio or the entry match. And then it'll be concrete stairs in front of that.
Okay. And then I just had a couple of suggestions. And one would be to select a front door that's more in keeping with the period style of the house, and then also to retain those original side lights. It just seems like anyone who's going to be purchasing the house would probably be an old house person who might enjoy those things.
Sure, sure.
And so those are just suggestions. And then also I would like to thank you all so much for taking care of that house.
We're very happy. You know, it's one of those that, you know, when you first walk the site and it was completely covered in all the trees and whatnot, you know, as you go to uncover it, it's just like, oh, this is amazing. <It's>, you know.
Well, I agree, and thanks for taking the project on.
Mm-hmm. Erica, my comments were just, I think I sent those previously, did you guys consider keeping the windows in the kitchen on the east and or in the closet on the north? And it really wasn't a requirement, but my comment was more just from the exterior composition of the house and the interior both.
We didn't consider it on the second floor, but in the kitchen, it has come up. And I think they're working with a kitchen designer right now. So there may end up being windows adjacent to where the stove is currently located. So a question I do have is, should that be what comes up, you know, as we work forward with the kitchen designers? Do we need to resubmit with that elevation for those windows, or how would that process actually work?
I think we could just put it in the motion as a option. That way, if it shows up, it doesn't have to be reviewed by our board.
Okay, that would be helpful. Thank you.
Sure. And I'm sorry, I didn't hear. Did you make a comment about the closet or bathroom? I was talking about the north side. You may have, but I missed it.
Yeah, on the north side. Yeah, just for functionality of where the sinks are and actually maximize every inch of that closet. I don't think we'd rather not have the window there if it's not required.
Yeah, not a requirement. I just like to ask these questions when I see them. One other thought came to my mind when I'm looking at this dark stucco. I don't know how, if you've done dark paint on stucco before, but I know commercially with EFIS, they kind of discourage it because of freeze thaw. If the color gets too dark on that, it can cause an issue for maintenance on stucco. Something you might want to look into. I'm just raising it as a question because I know I run into that. I've run into that in the EFIS world before. Just a word of, you know, maybe you've been there before, but just throwing that out.
That's a great comment. And I guess similar to the question, whereas we're working forward in the kitchen, if as we move forward with the contractor that will handle the patch and repair of the stucco, if their suggestion is to move to a lighter color, is that something that we do need to revisit with you guys, or is
No, the board is colorblind, so we don't really make comments. We do, you know, we have made comments on contrast. You'll hear that, like if we see that there's dark windows and you're putting in white, we'll point that out. But for me, I just saw on this one specifically as a professional architect that has run across this before, I just saw the dark color and it was just more of a comment from based on my own experience. So
sure. No, appreciated.
Yep, that's it. So okay, well, I think that's it for comments from our board, I believe. So with that, can I have a motion on 500 Gray?
Make a motion to approve 500 Gray with the following revisions. There'll be horizontal siding on the rear dormer on all sides. The existing front columns are to remain unless they are in disrepair, in which case they will be replaced by columns of the same style shown in the drawings. The motion also includes the option to include a window in the kitchen, which will match the style of the other windows in the house.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? Okay, 500 Gray is approved, Erica.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Have a good night.
You too.
With that, the meeting is adjourned. Thank you all. And good night.